I wasn't even recording. Hey, you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Codename Chanel, and I'm back. But clearly, I'm back to talk about my extreme phobia, my fear of the fruit orange. Okay? Okay, so yes, oranges, the fruit. I am extremely, extremely afraid of them. And I really want to bring awareness to this because I know there is other people who are, I've seen the one video on it and I've read articles. So if you are new to my channel, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up before you even watch it because I'm lit. If you're a returning subscriber, then it's all love and it's always gonna be love. Y'all, where do I start? Oh my God, where do I start? And also before I start this video, like, I just want anyone who can relate to fear of fruit, the fear of oranges, or any phobias, please comment below because this is serious. This is really serious. Let's get started. So, it was a point in time where I knew that this fear was irrational or just like crazy. And it was a point in time where, and I even read an article that said this, where you just think that it's a part of your personality trait. Like, this is it. I don't like oranges. I don't like to see oranges. I'm afraid of oranges. Like, I literally, for years, was just like, this is how it is, right? I never actually started to want to do the homework and dig on why this is one of my fears. And when I finally did, because I went to a therapist in 2015. Yes, I went to see an actual therapist. She started digging, and that when I was younger, oh my God, I don't even want to relive this, but this is my channel and I do want to be open about this. When I was younger, I had a room that was by an orange tree. Like, literally, here's the window and the orange tree was like right there. Now, it was a time where the room kind of had like a scent to it, like a bad scent. And my mother, she was like, oh, what's that smell? And they started like unlifting the mattress. Y'all, this is about to make me throw up. Oof. And there was like a rotten orange under the mattress that was like disgusting. Okay, disgusting. So my therapist came up with, okay, well, that's where it came from. Your fear of oranges is like, is because you, when you think of oranges, you think of this rotten fruit, right? Wrong. I kept telling her that yes, that was disgusting, but I remember before that time not liking oranges. Maybe that's where my hate came from, like my hate for oranges, but that is not where it came from. Like, I knew before that, like, the orange tree right there, I never wanted to sleep in my bed. Like, I always wanted to sleep in my mom's room. Like, y'all, I like a lot too.
Ooh, sorry. Like.
Anyway, but man, whoo, if anybody has a phobia, please comment below. I'm not playing. So I just told her, I was like, you know, that can't be it. And my therapist even tried to like show me pictures of oranges and stuff like that. And that doesn't freak me out as much as seeing an actual fruit, like an actual orange. And again, I don't know if this thumbnail, I'm going to put an actual image of a fruit or if I'm just going to use the emoji, because the fruit, seeing an actual real life image of an orange, I don't want that on my channel. I don't want that as a thumbnail. I don't want to have to, when I'm looking at my video, see that. So I might not do that, or I might not do anything of an orange. Like, okay. So I told her, it's, you know, been like that. I didn't stay with that therapist because, first off, I want to say something about her and, you know, the way that she was going about it, I feel like she was pressuring me. And I felt like one day I would walk into her office and there would be an orange. Like, I do. I felt like one day she would try to play me like that. So I decided to stop going to her altogether. And then my significant other was just like, he just didn't understand. So we had went to a wedding and there was like a fruit, like a whole fruit layout of fruits and stuff. So I seen oranges there. They were already peeled. Ooh, let me not talk about orange peels, y'all, because I can't do it. I can't do orange peels. Seeing orange peels, like, I can't do it. Y'all, I cannot. I can't believe I'm talking about this. Like, people probably gonna think I'm real life crazy. But I gotta get it out. I'm tired of holding it in, and I feel like somehow this is gonna help me. So he knew, so you know, he stayed away from the oranges, but we were all assigned at the table, and like people were getting, like, you know, it was the reception, I guess that's like afterwards, right? So people were bringing stuff or whatever, and I just remember his aunt bringing just like a whole plate. Y'all, I'm about to cry, and people gonna think I'm crazy. Y'all probably gonna think I'm crazy, and y'all gonna unsubscribe. But his aunt brought like a whole thing of fruit, and oranges was like the majority on the plate. And I just remember everybody, you know, sitting down, and I just remember getting up and just walking away and just feeling like a part of me was destroyed. Like, and then all of like, his family just thought I was rude. And he went about telling his family that I was allergic to oranges, and like even the scent of them, I could get sick. So his family understood. They were like, oh, okay, we didn't know that, you know. So when he started telling people I was allergic to it, I started doing that. Like at my job, I was a fruit cutter. Tell them, oh yeah, I'm allergic to oranges. Like I cannot with oranges. I'm allergic. They can't be around. So they actually, you know, rearranged everything or whatever, right? And so that became something too. That became telling people I'm allergic to oranges. That became a thing. But when one of your phobias control your life like that, you don't think like, oh, I have a fear of oranges. And then to like always see oranges around your whole life, because they're a very, very popular fruit. Orange juice, mimosas, like those things are popular. So to be living like this, it's kind of like, it's really hard. It's really, really hard. And I want to tell you guys about a time where before I told people I was allergic or anything like that, I was at a friend's house, and also a time when I got into my sister. Okay. So I was at a friend's house, and we were, you know, just chilling out or whatever. And then she started peeling oranges. And this is before the whole I'm allergic thing. And I didn't have, oh, I'm allergic in my head. So she started like peeling an orange or whatever. And then our other friend was in the kitchen. So when she was peeling the orange, I was like, if I don't look back or whatever, she's probably going to stay in the kitchen and eat her orange or whatever, right? So this is where I messed up. I tried to explain my phobia because I was so scared that she was going to come in the living room. So I told her like, girl, I have a phobia. I'm scared of oranges. Do you know what this girl did? She threw an orange peel at me, and I swear to you guys, like, I literally like, oh my gosh, I literally fell back. And they had like, okay, you see how this is a flower thing? She had like a glass vase with flowers in it, and I fell back, like, because she threw it at me. So she threw it at me, sorry to repeat this, but she literally threw it at me, and I fell back, and I broke their glass vase, and I cut myself, and this is a permanent scar that was there from that day. I'm not capping, because she threw an orange, and I just remember like just like going back like this, you know, and like falling back, and I didn't fall all the way back. Like I just remember trying to, you know how when you're trying to move out the way of something, and the glass vase was right there, and it shattered, and it cut me, and I didn't have to get stitches. Well, I'm trying to lie. It was a pretty bad open wound. You know, so I didn't have to get stitches, but yeah. After that, I mean, she was telling everybody like, oh, she's really scared of oranges. Like, she was just telling right that. And that's like something that, like, even at my job, bro, like, I had to tell them because they had like a thing of oranges in the kitchen. And I just, then y'all, I love my phone. But I literally dropped my phone and ran out. Like, I am like, oh, I wish I was making this up. I wish I was doing this for clout. I wish I was just saying this to be different. No, I am petrified of oranges, and I don't know. I tried to fix it over the years. And you know what? Anybody who doesn't have any phobias, like, kudos to you. Like, you are so lucky to not have to fear something, especially fear something that people think is a joke. I mean, you would think, oh, she's not the type of person that would say something like that or have a phobia like that, you know? And I am. And I'm like, and I don't know what to do. And I want to go back to therapy, but I'm scared that I will end up with a therapist like that. And as far as just life, I just go around avoiding oranges. I just go around. And I just want to say another thing too. It's another story where I was juicing for a few weeks because I was going to New York for my birthday last year. No, was New York my birthday last year? Yeah, New York for my birthday last year. Whoa, how time flies. And me and my sister decided to juice for a week and we were doing good. And I remember she had, bless my sister heart, I love her. Sissy, if you're watching this, you know I love you, but you had me messed up. I'm sorry, you had me messed up. Because she brought a bag of orange. And then like, here's my thing. I love my family so much. But if anybody knows me, my family knows me. And I feel like they try me the hardest with this phobia. Actually, I want to say that my brother, my older brother, he knows. He takes it very serious. He knows. He knows because he didn't see me just like flip out. But my sister, she tried to play me and she brought over a bag of oranges and like I kicked her out of my house and I started like cursing at her and I just started like calling her out of her name and stuff like that. And that's not okay. But just imagine, think of something that you're afraid of, like snakes or rats or something, and somebody walking in with a handful of snakes, because that's how I feel. That's my fear. That is my extreme fear. I'm afraid of them. And there's been some times where restrained myself from acting out just because I didn't want people to think I was crazy. So there has been some times where somebody had a mimosa and the juice is okay. Juice is okay. You won't catch me drinking it. But juice, if it's broken down into liquid form, that's okay. But if you have like, I don't even know if I can finish this. Like, because I don't want to describe it. Let me just say, I have restrained myself in public when someone has had an orange around me. But if you have numerous, it's no way I can hold. I can't. One, maybe. Orange peels, no. If it's an orange peel, I'm out. Then I want to get into my other phobias, which is because, you know, my boo thing, he know too. It's like circles. So, then y'all gonna be like, she doing too much. Okay, so circles, but mostly like, okay, so oranges, tangerines, anything that's orange and that's like circled fruit, I don't mess with it. Apples, I can work with it or whatever. Mangoes, I can work with it or whatever. Plums, Some reason I can't work with them. Nectarines and stuff like that, I try to avoid them. But it's not like oranges. It's not like oranges, but I try to avoid them. Circular things. If I see something that's circled that's in a corner. Oh, my God. Oh, disgusting. But really, it's just oranges. And, like, all the other stuff I can work around. That's pretty much all I have to say about that. I know people are going to think I'm crazy and probably think I'm making this up or... Oh, I hate them. I hate oranges. I swear to y'all, I hate oranges. I'm not capping. I have no reason to cap. I do not like oranges. They disgust me. Okay? And I'm sharing this with my channel because I feel like I'm basically sharing everything with y'all. Okay, for watching this video, if you were able to get through it and just not laugh at me. And if you have a phobia, please, please comment below. Please, please. I want to hear everybody, especially if it's something crazy, like you're afraid of shoes or something like that. Or I know there's some people that are like afraid of shapes, different shapes. And people who are afraid of swallowing, like, oh my God, please comment below. Follow me on Instagram, DM me. I want to talk about this, okay? I don't want to talk about finesse no more. I want to talk about this. We'll talk about other people with phobias. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Share it with anybody that you know have phobias. Go ahead and subscribe if you aren't already subscribed. Thank you so much for watching my videos. And as always, peace, love, and ratchetness. And I'm out.